put on glorious apparel. The Lord hath put on his apparel and girded himself with strength. He hath made the round world so sure that it cannot be moved. Ever since the world began hath thy seat been prepared. Thou art from everlasting. The floods are risen, O Lord, the floods have lift up their voice. The floods lift up their waves. The waves of the sea are mighty and rage horribly. But yet the Lord who dwelleth on high is mightier. Thy testimonies, O Lord, are very sure. Holiness becometh thine house for ever. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The lesson is written in the first letter of St. John, in chapter 1, at verse 3. What we have seen and heard we declare to you, so that you and we together may share in a common life, that life which we share with the Father and his Son, Jesus Christ. And we write this in order that the joy of us all may be complete. Here is the message we heard from him and pass on to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to be sharing in his life while we walk in the dark, our words and our lives are a lie. But if we walk in the light as he himself is in the light, then we share together a common life, and we are being cleansed from every sin by the blood of Jesus, his Son. If we claim to be sinless, we are self-deceived and strangers to the truth. If we confess our sins, he is just and may be trusted to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from every kind of wrong. But if we say we have committed no sin, we make him out to be a liar, and then his word has no place in us. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Thank you.
Let us pray. At this beginning of the penitential season of Lent, let us reflect on the words of Saint John, urging us to confess our sins and to walk in God's light. And so we pray to Jesus. Lord Jesus Christ, let your passion be our strength to sustain, guard, and protect us. Let the shedding of your blood cleanse us of all our sins. Let your death obtain eternal life for us, and let your cross lead us to everlasting glory. Let these constitute for us refreshment and joy, health and uprightness of heart, for your tender mercy's sake. Amen. We continue to pray for those who have asked us to pray for them, asking God to grant them his light and his peace. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.